diversity combined with AI and Gen AI. Why is this so important and how can organizations benefit? And also what kind of talents can we discover within organizations that probably are not involved right now? I'm here with an expert. We're here at MWC EY booth. It's the first day. We're really kicking off with Karyn Twaronite. You're the global officer at diversity, equity, and inclusion. Let's dive in with diversity. Why is it so important for organizations in the domain of AI?
Excellent. Yes, absolutely. D&I is critical for business. I would say it's really an innovation multiplier. The studies all show that companies that are more diverse, equitable, and inclusive have 57% more collaboration, they have higher productivity, higher efficiency, and they have 3.5 times more innovation levels. So that's tremendously important. So think about what businesses are dealing with right now. They're dealing with economic challenges, regulatory, government challenges, political challenges in the countries they're in, increased xenophobia and polarization. But they also need to deal with speed and innovation.
Correct.
So DE&I can really help with that.
But companies, most companies are not aware of this. How can they make this happen? How can they either have this diverse workforce included?
Well, you need to have a diverse workforce across all differences. That's not just women, men. Mm-hmm. It means across many identities. Mm-hmm. And most people identify as many things. Mm-hmm. And it's their individual choice to do that. But you need to start at the employee level to make sure that employees feel like they belong. Mm-hmm. Because you can have the diversity, but without the inclusion, people are just feel like outsiders.
Yeah.
If they feel like they belong, the studies also show that it's incredibly valuable for the health and well-being of employees as well. So that allows them to create at their innovative level, to be able to collaborate more and to contribute at their best. But that's how you can maximize the opportunity.
And you were addressing a special group of very smart people, but not always addressed or included within the workforce.
That's right.
Can you explain that?
Well, for example, you do have people in underrepresented populations that can feel even more like outsiders versus insiders in their company. And it's of a business's best interest to make sure that all people feel like insiders, not just some people. And historically, people would hear the words diversity and they only think it's a benefit or accommodation for some people. And perhaps not, they don't feel included. We try to be very explicit at EY that this is about everyone and so that everyone can have the opportunity to thrive.
And can you give an example of this special group?
Yeah, so an example of a diversity dimension that tends to be under-hired in the talent pool, and especially in technology, includes neurodivergent professionals. And that can include, for example, at EY, we hire people on the autistic spectrum, ADHD, dyslexia, etc. And the point being that they are not what's considered neurotypical, but they bring tremendous amount of skills, technical and technology aptitude, data and pattern recognition. So for technology, this is very valuable. And this is not necessarily new to us. It's not like we're suggesting that others do this. This has been huge value to us. We've started developing our neurodiversity centers of excellence back in 2016. So we've been doing this with two other tech companies, Microsoft and SAP, since our inception. And now I'm pleased to share that we have these neurodiversity centers of excellence in 23 cities across 10 countries. And we're building more. And it's really helped to benefit our business internally as well as externally. And the reason why we talk about this population is because 1 in 5 people around the world are considered neurodivergent. And actually, you're an influencer, 53% of Gen Z who are ages 18 to 25 self-identify as being neurodivergent and neurodistinct. So with that, it's a huge population, not only to include in the talent pool, but for AI, as an example, to include in the build stage, the creative stage, as well as in the feedback stage, to make sure that whatever is being produced and built is representative of that population as well.
And which makes an opportunity for the Gen Z to differentiate themselves, but also for the organizations to really benefit.
Absolutely.
I really appreciate you addressing this because it's an important topic, but I think not most organizations, they don't know about it.
Thank you.
Thank you for watching here from the EY booth at MWC, and looking forward to seeing you next time.